Hi, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 12th episode to create an e-commerce website using WooCommerce. In the previous episode, we work on the shop page and today we'll work on the FAQ page. First of all, let's create a new custom post type UI. So open your admin panel. Go to custom post type UI and click on add or edit post types. Then you can fill up this information. I will call it FAQS. Then if you go all the way to the bottom, I'll just select title and editor over here. And then I can click on add post type. Now if you want to add the FAQ, you can add in the section and click on add new. You can then keep on adding the content over here. You can add your content in this classic block. Once done, you can click on this publish button. And now I'll pause my video and keep on adding all the FAQs. Once we finish adding all the FAQs, now it's time for us to create a new template for this page. So open your project folder, go to WP content, themes, eFashion, templates, and then you can copy any one of the template file and then rename it to template FAQ. You can then open that template file and change the template name. Now let's remove all of these blocks except the brand block, because we can reuse it for the custom post type that we have recently created. So first of all, I want to rename this class name to open close. Then I can change this custom post type UI name from brands to FAQS. And then here I want to show the title, so I will just use _title. I can remove this li and I can also remove this ul. Then I need the content, so I will just use _content over here. Now let's refresh the site and you should see some changes in the FAQ page. Now all we are missing is the FAQ title and the styles. So to add the title, you can open the shop page and by using the developer tool, you can grab the code. I will add it over here just after the container. Change the title to FAQ. Then here I want to add div with a class called holder, and for the title I want to add the s3 tag. And for content I want to add another div with a class called content. Now refresh the page and you should see the changes. Here you go. Now, the last thing we need to do is to add the open close functionality using jQuery in main.js. So open your main.js. And here I will call it open close. Now, the first thing in main.js I want to do is to hide this content. So I will use this hide, and here I will use the class name called content. Now if you refresh the site, the content should be hidden by default. Now the second thing we need to do is to add the click event in this S3 tag. So this is the S3 tag. So just after this one, let's add the click event. So when I click on this S3 tag, I want to toggle this div class content, and currently our div class content is located just next to this S3 tag. So our code will be something like this: this dot next dot slide toggle. Refresh the page. And your toggle should be working. Now the final thing I want to do is to add a class called OpenCloseActive so that this icon will change to minus whenever I click on this item. To do so, just after this one, I want to add this dot toggle class, and then the name of the class that I want to add. Now refresh the site, and you can see the minus icon whenever you click on the item. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll work on the blog page. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.